Hey everyone, welcome back. In this video, what we'd like to do is compare three vintage turntables against a modern turntable in terms of objective test data, including harmonic and intermodulation distortion. And we're also going to test the frequency response. So by utilizing a test LP developed by the National Research Council here in Canada, I'm able to capture the output of the Phono stage directly into ARTA, into the ARTA measurement software. And so let's get started on some test results, and we're going to see just how these turntables fare. So the Phono preamp that I'm using is a mid-90s NAD C160 preamp, and then the ADC input box is the E1DA Cosmos. So I put a link there if you want to check it out. It's a very low distortion input box. The noise floor is around 120 dB or better. And so you can see here in my test setup, I have the NAD preamp. And so you can see the Phono or the turntable is connected into the Phono input of the preamp. I'm going to be using both moving coil and moving magnet, depending on which turntable I'm testing. And then the pre-out of the preamp then goes to the input box here, and then off to my laptop to the measurement software. So the idea here is to look at the distortion performance and frequency response flatness, both between a modern table, in this case a Thorin's RP2, and against three vintage turntables. And so we'll see that in detail in a little bit. So the audio test record, like I mentioned, is developed by the National Research Council here in Canada. And you can see here on the back of it, if you want to check out and read some of the tests that are included in the LP, then post a link to my blog and you can just read through. There's a little leaflet that's included, and you can see here, again, it just extends through the different tracks and what the different tests are supposed to do in terms of fine tuning of your turntable. So the first turntable that we're testing is a vintage Toshiba Orax SRD350 direct drive turntable. And then the cartridge is a Microacoustics MA2002, which has a beryllium arm. And so you can see here, this is the turntable itself with the cartridge. So the first test that we're going to look at is intermodulation distortion. And so one of the tracks has a 1 kilohertz plus 1.5 kilohertz test tone. So using the real-time spectrum analyzer within the ARTA software, you can see here the two tones present along with its sideband products. So you can see here I've labeled each one. Now IMD2 is the most dominant, so that's the one where that we're going to focus on. And so how you read it is basically you take the top of the test tone and then you look at how far down the products are in the vertical scale, which is in dB. So here with the Orax slash Toshiba turntable, we can see that we have 30 dB of dynamic range. And so that will be our benchmark to see if the other tables can beat this. And the next test is simply harmonic distortion using a single 1 kilohertz sine tone. So here you can see that harmonic distortion is 50 dB down. And so there's a few takeaways from this. First of all, when it comes to second harmonic, it's pretty benign. It's not very representative of overall sound quality. In fact, it can actually be preferable having a little bit of second order. It adds a bit of richness or smoothness to the sound. However, it's a little bit more questionable as you move up into the higher orders. So for example, the third order is almost into the noise floor. So the 50 dB is quite a bit lower distortion than what we're seeing generated when we introduce the second tone here, being the 1.5 kilohertz test tone. We see that the turntable responds in a very negative way when you start introducing multi-tones into the test signal. And so that's an interesting takeaway, just generally in regards to overall turntable performance. The third test that we're doing is the frequency response. And so the test record has pink noise, which allows us to see the frequency response. And so The downward trend that you see here is actually the transfer function of pink noise, the power response of pink noise itself. Just technically, it's not going to be flat. But what we can gather is just the overall, you know, we see a little bit of a bump in the very upper treble, in the kind of the 13, 14 kilohertz. And then there's a bit of a bump there around the 1.5 kilohertz. So that's just the takeaway there. We compare the linearity. If we were to draw a target curve, it would simply be a perfectly straight line with that downward slope. Okay, so the second of the four turntables is the Raga RP2. And so the cartridge that we're using is the ND3. So this turntable is about $1,000 Canadian, and it's brand new, fully calibrated from the dealer. And so let's take a look at what we have. So using the exact same test, the Aurex is able to achieve 35 dB intermodulation distortion. So it's a moderate improvement compared to the Toshiba turntable, where we saw it at around 30 dB. So moving on, looking at harmonic distortion, we can see here that the harmonic is at minus 45, which is not quite as good of a result there that we saw with the Toshiba at minus 50. But like I mentioned, it's not really a strong correlation there in terms of the actual sound quality, but it's interesting to see that result nonetheless. So here's the pink noise frequency response result. We see kind of an uplift in the treble. That's going to be about a 5 or 6 dB upward tilt into the the 15 kilohertz region. Otherwise, it's pretty linear across the frequency spectrum. So the next turntable is a vintage Thorens TD145, and it's using the moving coil DL103 cartridge from Denon. So it would be a modern classic since it's still available, handmade in Japan. And if you're interested, if you do a Google search on the DL103, there's an interesting YouTube video where they feature the factory in Japan showing how these cartridges are actually made. So we can see here that the IMD is even better on this table, minus 38 dB, where the Raga was minus 35. And then we also see that the low frequency noise is also good at minus 43 dB. Intermodulation distortion is comparable to the Toshiba at minus 48 dB. Looking at frequency response, we can see that the DL103 Thorens combo is quite linear, almost perfect, in fact, with no kind of bumps or wiggles through the response. And even into the treble, we see excellent performance. So the fourth turntable in the test is a vintage Luxman PD264, and it's using a modern cartridge, Audio-Technica, the VM540ML, which is Audio-Technica's most popular cartridge. It's about $300 US to purchase. And so this is a direct drive turntable. And we can see here that the Luxman Audio-Technica combo exceeds everything else with IMD at about minus 40 dB. And then we also see very low noise through the low frequency. Okay, so then with the harmonic distortion, we're at minus 45. And then looking at the frequency response, we do see something very, very peculiar in that we see an upward trend towards the 8 kilohertz region, and then it falls quite gradually beyond that. And so it's a bit concerning to see this. I'm not sure if it's related to perhaps some damage to the cartridge. But it's definitely worth further investigation on this one. But we do see, good performance in terms of IMD. I should note too that when doing these tests, there's a few things that I observed. First, when conducting the test tone, because it's real time, I had to be absolutely quiet during the test. I did the test in my workshop, And if there was any kind of a noise, then you would start to see this noise floor start to bump up. And so even my voice talking would introduce an elevated noise floor through the actual, so basically the cartridge is acting as a microphone and would pick up my voice and then raise this noise floor. And so obviously in terms of your speakers reproducing sound, that's going to be a significant factor in the noise floor of the turntable itself. And so mechanical and acoustic isolation becomes a very key component in keeping distortion low. Whether it becomes higher than these IMD products, that's something that could be a future test to see. But certainly it's showing up in the measurements that I did. Okay, so conclusions, what do we know from these tests? It revealed differences from between the various turntables. And the second thing that I discovered is that the modern turntable, the Raga RP2, was not the clear winner. All four turntables performed relatively close to one another in terms of IMD, only varying about 5 dB. The distribution of IMD products, they varied. If you look at the test results, you can kind of see various distributions. However, the IMD2 remained the most prominent distortion factor. The IMD products are higher than noise generated by AC mains hum. And so another observation is that the frequency response varied considerably. Harmonic distortion is predominantly second order, and the higher order harmonics, third and fourth harmonics, are almost completely into the noise floor. And then another observation is that the IMD or intermodulation distortion is much higher than harmonic distortion. So what we don't know, okay, so the impact that IMD has on subjective sound quality, and so it's generally known that IMD is more offensive to the ear than harmonic, but what the impact that has on the subjective sound quality of the turntable, I don't know. So that's would be a future test to see whether if we were to reduce IMD in some way, whether that would actually translate into improved sound quality. So one thing that we don't know is the overall contribution of the phono stage in terms of both types of distortion. And we also don't know the contribution of the test album on both types of distortion. And so we can't just assume that the test album itself is completely free of distortion. It would have, it's inevitable that it itself would have some quantity of distortion itself. So affected. And so just to tally all of the results here, I've put it just all four of them together. So you can kind of just make a visual quick comparison. But what we can gather from this is that they all have very similar performance in terms of the result. And so we can see just visually, yes, the table's very, very, very little. So here again, harmonic distortion, the four results displayed together just for quick reference, and then also frequency response. So lastly, the question was, and this is a bit of an addendum to all of this, the question of the impact of the phono stage itself on the distortion results. And so I simply tested the phono stage alone to see what the two-tone test tone would look like. And so obviously in this case, I didn't use the test LP. I used the tone generator option or feature within the ARTA software. And so generated those tones, ran it through the phono stage, and then back into my E1DA ADC box. And so you can see here, this is the result of the two-tone test for the NAD phono stage. And so it's literally generating no IMD whatsoever. And so that just simply confirms that the distortion that we are seeing is either from the turntable itself or, like I mentioned, the test record. An interesting test. It sets a baseline at least for further changes or modifications or calibration to the turntable itself, whether it means reinforcing, dampening, or isolation, various techniques to improve the objective measurements in an effort to improve the overall sound quality. And so I felt like this would be a unique approach to take, looking strictly at the test data. Now, you may question whether the listening tests of the turntables correlate towards the measurements. And so, to be honest, all of the turntables sounded very similar. There wasn't one that jumped out as significantly better than the other. So in that sense, the data does corroborate against that. So I've been using the Luxman with the Audio Technica for 2 years. And so it's my personal turntable. And so the Raga RP2 was recently purchased by my brother as an upgrade. And then the Thorns was the turntable that he's been using for a number of years. And so the Denon cartridge, the DL103, seemed to be a very interesting performer, in that I may want to buy his cartridge off of him and install it on my Luxman turntable. I think that would be an interesting combination. This post is not affiliated with any brand, where I'm simply doing this out of my own curiosity, just in case you're wondering. None of the products or hardware was given to me by anybody. It's simply my brother and I and our own curiosity on this. So I hope you found this enjoyable. Take care and have a great day.